Coventry Cathedral has no full-time choir school. Every morning in term time, boys arrive at 7:45 for an hour's rehearsal before going off to the city's schools. Not just in church, but in the homes and streets of Coventry, so many still remember.
It isn't a memory of war. It's a memory of the people that we've lost. You must realise that all these young soldiers at that particular time were the, what can you say, were the youth of the country who died giving hope that we should have peace for this country. Now, have we got to forget them? No.
This event, this 50th anniversary, will actually help, I think, maybe in a way, to lay old ghosts for a lot of people. I think, talking to a lot of old people that lived through it, they felt that they hadn't been recognised, that their story hadn't been told, and they were desperate to tell it. So I think that in some way, the commemoration will actually help to sort of bring this to the surface. And I think it will bring it to a whole new layer of people that don't really understand precisely what Coventry went through and why it is so significant to the city.